you click the patient, then you click the find, then you search the patient you want to open or go round up. You double click that, okay. Then you click this sign, then the list comes. Here a lot of things are there. You don't have to worry about those things. Just click the list. P1 means OPG. Volume 1, volume 2 means that is CBCT. Okay. CBCT or CBVT. Cone beam computed tomography or cone beam volumetric. This is OPG. OPG definitely we should have
Condyle.
OPG definitely we should have Condyle. Look in that order, any OPG. Don't look the tooth which are going. It won't take more than few microseconds to look all these things. The Condyle, coronoid, maxilla, sinus. Then you come here. First always see the external circle. This is the external circle. The Condyle, the posterior border of the mandible, the lower border of the mandible, then complete the left side, joint everything, then the inner circle, coronoid process, is external oblique ridge, the bone, canal, everything, mental foramen, everything, then the maxillary sinus, then the nose, midline, septum. I'm done. Okay. Maxillary sinus. Then look the finer details. Then look the in each and individual tooth. Okay. So look the OPG in three circles. The first circle is condyle, posterior border of ramus, angle, lower border, any break. Especially if there is history of trauma, then you have to look this very carefully. Otherwise, no. Okay, condyle. Then the second circle, coronoid, this external oblique ridge, canal. Canal course, bone quality, here mental foramen, here the midline, anterior lingual foramen, mental foramen, inferior lobar canal, okay, everything. Then the sinus, whether the sinus is blackish on both sides or it is slightly opaque, okay. Then the nasal cavity, midline, nasal septum, any deviation of the nasal septum, these things, okay. Then look the each and individual tooth, any decay, root, caries, bone level, everything. Okay. If you look in this way, you won't miss a thing. For example, recently one trauma patient came. Okay. So initially the picture sent was like this, right? Even though condyle was captured in OPG, but the picture sent was only like this. And condyle, so that is the importance. So when she sent the condyle, with the condyle, we can see a clear fracture. Still, we didn't have the condyle on the right side. We don't know whether there is fracture or not, but we referred to the patient, right? Even here, there may be some slight fracture, I don't know, okay? So we'll go back to Ronda. So this is how you look the OPG in from the outer circle, come the middle circle, then look the fine details. Then you can look the fine details in the IOPA. If you take IOPA, you can look still more fine details. Okay. So the OPG is like looking a group photo. Okay, looking at a IOPA is taking a selfie. Okay, so never miss these things. Always look from the outer. By rush, we try to see that particular right. We try to see the particular region, but avoid that mistake. Avoid that temptation. Don't behave like a dentist. Look from the circle. Whether the patient is don't have any issue, don't worry. You can find lot of things that we will discuss later. You can observe lot of things in these two circles. Okay. Now I will tell how to open the CBCT. So volume. So we'll open. Volume 1 means it was taken first. Volume 2 means it was taken in chronological order. So you will be getting initially these 4 boxes. 1, 2, 3, 4. Some items here. Here you can see curved slicing, custom slicing, oblique slicing, review. Okay, so 3 slicing and 1 review. Okay, don't worry about the review. Okay, there are only 3 slicings. In 3 way you can cut the face and you can see. Okay, in 3 ways you can cut it and see. Okay, here the most important part is curved slicing. The most important part is curved slicing. So you will be drawing a arch form here. Click the manually create a arch, then you will be clicking a arch form. Okay, so I am not going into it. Okay, before going to the arch form, you have to slide this fully from top to bottom. Okay, the yellow is the slide. Okay, if I am holding this and moving like this, from caudal to cranium direction it goes. Okay, so what section you are seeing is axial section. Correct. Axial section means you think you are having an axe and you are cutting like this. The imagination you can remember like this. So axial section you have to look first. Okay, see the lower border full of cortical bone, then the medullary bone. Okay, you can observe the mental foramen is entering here. Okay, you can see the lingual, that bulge, genial tubercles. Okay, then you have started seeing the apex. Okay, then it must be the edentulous area. Okay, then we are coming to the topmost occlusal level. Okay, here it is the ramus. Then we are entering the interocclusal space, occlusal air space. That is why there is air. It must be tongue. Then we are entering the maxillary occlusal space, then maxillary root area, root apex. Okay, then you are entering the nose, clearly the sinus area. Sinus area, these are the concha, midline, septum. Then we are entering the classic nose, right? Here also you can correlate. Here also you can correlate. You have to do this first. Formal scan, this is called formally you are seeing the entire area. Why we have to see this now? Because once you draw the arch form, there will be lines all over. You cannot see this section clearly. Now we have to decide which arch you have to see. Okay. Suppose the patient is having problem in the lower arch. So we have to draw for the lower arch. If you want to see the upper arch, you have to draw the upper arch, then you have to separately see. Don't try to see the both the arches in single section. Okay. See, analyze the each arch separately. First we have to see the lower arch. Okay, let us think that the patient is having some problem in the lower arch, so we have to see the lower arch. So where we have to keep this yellow line and we have to draw the arch form. Here we are doing mistakes. What you are doing is you keep the line near the occlusal aspect, or you keep the yellow line near the very much lower border and you draw the arch line. This will give wrong sections. Okay, so where we have to keep the yellow line? In the root middle. Okay, middle of the root. Okay, so this is the occlusal surface, right? Now we are entering the crestal bone. Okay, now it must be the root, mid from the apex to the crest, mid root tentatively. Then you draw the arch form. The arch form should be in the middle. Then finish it with a double click. Okay, now we have a perfect arch form. Okay, after that you have to adjust this slider. Okay, if it is like this, you may not see the lingual side or this. only if you see, then you can see the nasopalatine canal. If it is small, then you cannot see the lingual curvature or the canal at all. Now we are going to see the mandible. Of course, you know this we have to adjust to 14 or 20 mm. Okay, now we are getting the, once you draw the arch form, you are getting the four boxes. Okay, four boxes. What are the boxes? Axial section, one box. Okay, curved slicing means along the curvature. Curved slicing along the curvature, you are slicing it. Okay, we are getting four boxes. One is the axial section. Now you cannot see the axial section clearly now because there are lines. That is why you have to see the axial view before you draw the arch. Okay, you got it. Yellow line is almost in the middle thread. Okay, tentatively. Now we are getting the four boxes. These four boxes are the important one. Okay. Initially you got the four boxes, but they are not used. These are the useful ones. This is axial section. Don't worry about the axial section because you have seen it already. Don't worry about the axial section now. This is the panoramic section. Along this, it is spread out like this. Panorama. Okay. This is also not very much important. Why? Because already you have seen the OPG. Okay. This view. Okay. This is a 3D reconstructed view. Is this important? This is also not very much important. Don't do your diagnosis with using this. This gives a lot of errors. Okay. This gives a lot of errors. If there is bone loss only 40 or 60%, it shows the bone loss as 100%. If the bone loss is 10%, it will show the bone loss as 50 or 60%. So if the bone losses are 50 or 60%, you will see it as a no bone. But actually there will be bone. This may be useful to educate the patient. The patient will understand this image more clearly than this image. But not for treatment planning. For example, I will tell you this. See, imagine, it shows there is no bone here. It shows there is no bone here. But actually there is bone there. It may be very thin, but it shows that there is no bone. Right or wrong? Now this yellow line, you can move bodily or you can change the angle like this. Okay, there are two dots. Okay, so these things are you are doing. How to do it, I will tell you. So the tooth in question is the premolar. Okay, so keep the line along the apex, which runs through the apical surface and the apex. Okay, don't keep it like this. We need to see the apex exactly at the apex, right? So if you keep it like this, you are missing the apex. So only these two boxes are important. This box is more important. Okay. Okay. So this is the correct view, right? But sectioning it along the occlusal and apex area. Now this is the view. If I am seeing the lower anterior, I am changing the angulation so that it runs to the apex.